Hello students, I am Abhishek Mishra from Sutri Global Academy. Now I am going to teach you the first chapter of the Flamingo. There are two books of NCERT in English, and first is the Flamingo, second is Vistas. And today I am going to start the first chapter. The name of the first chapter is the last lesson, as it is mentioned here. So look at here, my dear students. The last lesson is written by Alphonse Daudet. Alphonse Daudet, he is a French novelist. And he got good name and fame in the field of the novel and short stories. Whatever he wrote in his career, in his life, he wrote about the nationality, and he made people aware about how to keep our tradition, culture, and mother tongue. Now, I would like to tell you one thing that's very important to you all, that the last lesson, if you would like to cover, there is a need to go through the certain things. And what are the certain things? You will have to keep in your mind before going to take your concern of this chapter. First, you will have to go through the introduction. What is the means base and what is the background of this chapter? First, I shall teach you this means introduction. Second is characters, how many characters in this chapter? Third is theme, what is the theme? What is the central idea? What is the plot of this chapter? Next is the message. What is the accurate message? Which type of message Alphonse Daudet, means French novelist, he wants to convey the message to the worldly people through this chapter. And after that, I shall go through the brief summary. This is the very important because it is the root of the chapter. Next is the vocabulary. If you know the vocabulary, definitely you will be able to understand the chapter rightly. And last important thing is that important questions. Because we will also discuss at the last of this chapter about the important questions and those questions which have already come in the board examination and which will be the considerable to come in the next means following of the year coming of examination. So first I would like to start introduction without wasting too much time. So look at my dear, actually it was a time. The time was that means there was a war means between Franco and Persian. Franco means France. It was a time, Persia, if we talk about the Persia, means it was the part of the Germany. You can say that there was a war between France and Germany. It was a time. Persia was the consisted of Germany. Consisted means part of the Germany. And there was a war. And war was, means, the time was 1870 to 1871. In the war, France was defeated by Persia. If we talk about Persian, means Persia, P-R-U-S-S-I-A, Persia. And in that war, France lost two districts. And the name of the two districts is Alsace and Lorraine. And what happened in that war? France lost two districts, Alsace and Lorraine, in which means Germany, Persia, Alsace and Lorraine both went into the hand of the Persian army, Persian soldier. You can say both went to the means Germany. And what happened after that? Means this is the means region of the chapter. This is the background of this chapter. Now I would like to tell you that this chapter, the last lesson, it revolves around one of the protagonists, one of the important character, one of the major character of this chapter. The name of the major character is the Hamel. Hamel, if we talk about, revolves around the means this character Hamel. He is a very devoted teacher, French language teacher. He is the teacher of the Alsace. He is the teacher of the one of the districts of the France. The name of the dead district is Alsace. He is very devoted. He always tries to make people aware about the importance of the mother tongue and about the importance of the culture. Now, I would like to tell you about the characters. This is the introduction. If there is any query, you can ask. This is very important. Now, next is the characters. Before going to start about the character, first I would like to tell you one thing that's very important. First, look at the characters. There are four major characters in which, if we talk about Hamel, he is a protagonist. Protagonist means one of the important characters of this chapter because the entire chapter revolves around Hamel. And second character is the French. French, if we talk about the first, I would like to tell you about Hamel. Hamel, he is a French language teacher. He is the teacher of one of the schools of the Alsace. He is a very devoted teacher. He is a true patriot. He always tries to make people aware about the importance of the mother tongue, about the importance of the, means you can say, the tradition and culture of the means Franz, once he spoke to the people and his students that Franz is one of the means best logical language of the world. Now, I would like to tell you about another character. The another character of this chapter is Franz. Franz, he is a school-going lad. If we talk about the lad, my dear, so first look at here. Lad means boy. So Franz, he is a school-going lad. School-going lad means school-going means boy. I would like to tell you that actually having a poor family setup, he was not interested to take the class. He was not able to take even the attend the class. Most of the time, his parents, they ask him to do work in the means in meal. In the meal means to earn money, not to attend the class. So he becomes very interested not to take the class. He start taking interest out of the class. Most of the times he passes his time out of the class. Even he does not take interest to attend the class. But one of the most important thing I would like to tell you that in spite of all, in addition to all, he is a very acute observer. He is a very, he has a good sense of understanding. I would like to say one thing, acute sense of understanding. Acute sense of understanding means he was a good observer. Because when he comes to know that, it is the last lesson of the French language, he becomes very sad. When he comes to know that. Now, M. Hamel, one of the devoted teacher, who sincerely taught in one of the schools of the Alsace, 40 years, he becomes very, unhappy, and he decides to attend the last class of the last lesson. Now, I would like to go through the next character, very important character, Blacksmith. You can say, he is a very minor character. There is only one, at one place, his role is there. Blacksmith is also called Watcher. I shall tell you, when I shall teach you brief summary, I shall tell you that what is the role of the blacksmith. How, sir? If we talk about this character, he is a very important character in this chapter because he decides to attend the last lesson, the last class of the M. Hamel along with the villagers because he wants to give the sincere, you can say the farewell, he wants to give this, means he wants to even give the right devotion, even you can say that respect to the M. Hamel for his 40 years sincere teaching. 40 years. Who taught in the same school of the Alsace 40 years? M. Hamel. Why did Hauser along with the villagers, they came to attend the last class? Because of his 40 years sincere services. Even he became very sad along with other villagers also. When they came to know that, it is the last lesson of the French language and M. Hamel is going to leave the class next day onwards, we will learn German language. Now, I have discussed about the character introduction. You know what is the introduction of this chapter, characters. Now, I would like to tell the theme. If we talk about the theme of this chapter, so my dear students, you should come to know that actually we see that in that war, we talk about a war between France and Persia. What happened in this war? Those who got victory, means Persian army. You can say the Persia means Germany got victory. Understood? And they became very arrogant. They became very proud. And when a person, he becomes very arrogant or proud, he always try to snatch others' freedom. So what happened in this chapter? That in the chapter, the same thing happened. Germany means Persia, wants to snatch their rights, even they want to rule over their mind and heart. Who wants to rule over their mind and heart? Persian soldier, Persian army. They wanted to rule over the mind and heart of the France, mind and heart of the Alsace and Lorraine, two districts of the France. Already I have told you that in that war, France lost two districts of its country, Alsace and Lorraine. So, I hope that you have come to know that if we talk about the theme of this chapter, we should never try to snatch others' right. We should always try to respect everybody's culture and tradition. Now, I would like to proceed for the next one, that is very important, that is the message. If we talk about the message of this chapter, it is a very clear message. If we talk about the message of this chapter, it's a very clear message that if you would like to teach your coming generation the values of culture, tradition, rites, decorum, there is a need. For what? There is a need to keep our mother tongue safe and sound. Because you cannot teach your coming generation values of mother tongue, values of rights, values of civilization, culture, tradition, by the time you do not keep your mother tongue close to your heart. So what is the need? What exactly Alphonse Daudet wants to convey to the worldly people? He wants to convey to the worldly people that if you would like to teach your coming generation the value of your culture. Culture means you know. And if we talk about the rites. Rites means sanskar. If you would like to teach your means coming generation, rites, decorum, there is a need to keep your coming generation close to their heart. And what is that weapon? The weapon is that your mother tongue. So I hope that you have come to know that what is the message of this chapter? The message of this chapter is that we will have to keep in our mind and heart our value of mother tongue, culture, tradition, civilization, decorum, and rights to lead our coming generation on the right track. Now, I would like to tell about the brief summary. My dear students, before going to start a brief summary, there are certain things I would like to resume first. Now look at the ones through this chapter. The last lesson is written by Alphonse Daudet. He is a French novelist. And he got good name and fame in the field of novel and short stories. If we talk about the introduction of this chapter, the introduction of this chapter is that this chapter was entirely depend on the war between 1870 to 1871 between Franco and Prussian. Franco and Prussian and led by, I would like to tell you one about the one person, led by Bismarck, B-I-S-M-A-R-C-K. Bismarck. Who is Bismarck? He is a very good ruler of the Germany. Under his supervision, Germany got good name and fame, good power, means across the world. So you will have to keep in your mind that there was a war between France and Persia, and it was a time 1870 to 1871 in which, means how did Persia got victory over France? Because of what? Because of the Bismarck. And he got victory over two districts of the France. The name of the two districts of the France is Alsace and Lorraine. And if we talk about the Hamel, where Hamel was a teacher? Hamel was a teacher in one of the schools of the Alsace. Now introduction clear, but I would like to tell you that this chapter also revolves around one of the important character, one of the protagonist, Hamel. Who was Hamel? Hamel was a French language teacher. He is a very devoted teacher. He is a true patriot. He always tries to devote his life, his time, to teach his students about the right education related to the society, related to the country, related to the mother tongue. Now, I would like to tell you about the next part, that is the characters. Introduction confirmed. Now look at the characters. If we talk about the characters, there are four characters already I have taught you. Hamel and Franz. Who is Franz? Franz is a school-going lad. School-going lad means he is a student of one of the school of the Alsace where Hamel was a teacher. Understood? Now, I would like to tell about the next point. That's very important. Having poor family setup. He always asked by his parents not to attend the class. In the place of attending class, there is a need to go to work in the mill to earn some money. That's why he is not interested to take class He was interested outside of the world, outside of the class. Most of the times, he plays with the nature. Most of the times, he was very fond of watching Persian soldier drilling. Persian soldier drilling means, I would like to tell you about the drilling, D-R-I-L-L-I-N-G. Drilling means practice. So, who was very fond of watching Persian soldier drilling? French was very fond of watching Persian soldier drilling. And he was also very fond of listening birds chirping. He was very fond of French. Understood? In spite of all, in addition to all, he was means acute observer. He had a good quality to observe the situation. He had acute sense of understanding. When he came to know that, it was the last lesson of the M. Hamel and it was the last class of French language, he became very sad because he lost his golden opportunity to learn his mother tongue. Now next day and tomorrow onwards, he would not be able to learn French language. He will be taught German language in the place of French language because of what? Because in the war, Franco and Persian, France lost what? Two districts, Alsace and Lorraine. Now confirm. Look at the next is Blacksmith. He was a watcher. Already I have discussed to you. How, sir? He was an old person. He came along with the villagers. He came along with the villagers to attend the last class of M. Hamel to give the what? To give the respect. To give the respect to M. Hamel for his 40 years sincere teaching. Now, character is clear. Theme already I have taught you that it is definitely happens that whenever a country means gets victory over other country, definitely that country wants to snatch the rights, culture, values, tradition, mother tongue of the dead country. So if we talk about the theme of this chapter, we should never try to snatch, we should never try to take others' culture, values, and we should never try to dominate on others' mother tongue. Now, if we talk about the message, Alphonse Daudet wants to convey a message to the worldly people that we should always try to keep our mother tongue safe and sound. Because if we keep our mother tongue, culture, tradition, values, rights, civilization close to our heart, we will be able to teach our coming generation the same things and we will be able to lead our generation how to keep and how to lead a right and right track. Now, I hope completed. Now, this is the brief summary. This is a very important part. That's why I once resumed all these things. Now, look at the brief summary. Before going to this brief summary, I would like to tell you one thing. That M. Hamel, he was a French teacher, French language teacher. He was teaching in his class participle grammar. What is participle grammar? I'm not going to teach you right now participle, but my dear students, for your better acknowledgement, I would like to tell you there are three types of the participle grammar. Present participle, past participle, perfect participle. But it is not time to teach you grammar. It is a time to teach you that means M. Hamel, he was a French language teacher. It was a time he was teaching in his class participle grammar. He announces in his class that tomorrow I shall make question related to the participle grammar. If we talk about French, he was a student of the M. Hamel. He decides not to attend the class of the M. Hamel next day because he doesn't know the ABCD of the means participle grammar. Now here is the question, that why does he decide not to attend the class of M. Hamel? There are three reasons. First reason is that he is not quite interested to attend the class of M. Hamel. Second is M. Hamel is a very strict teacher. He never passes any students. He never means what? He never likes those students who does not do his homework or classwork. And third is very important. He always punishes those students who are reckless. So he decides not to attend the class of the M. Hamel next day. I hope that is now clear. So what happened after that? Next day, he realizes that. What does he realize? He decides not to attend the class and he decides to go through the school fence. If we talk about the fence, fence means boundary of the school. He sees that, you can say he saw that, there was a gathering in front of the notice board. Actually, it was a time, there was not a print media. So every types of the official and means you can say the official announcement was means used to written on the notice board. So there was a gathering in front of the notice board, and on that notice board, what was written? He was unable to understand what was written there. So before reaching there, he realizes that there is no hustle and bustle. There is no bustle in the what? In the school. So he thinks that perhaps it is the Sunday morning, because there is no hustle and bustle. If we talk about the bustle, I would like to tell you that bustle. Bustle means what? Din. Din means commotion. Commotion means what? Noisy place. So he realizes that there was no, means what? There was no bustle in the fence. On the other hand, when he goes in front of the notice board, he comes to know that. What does he come to know? He comes to know that there is an order came from Berlin. What has come from Berlin? Berlin means what? Capital of Germany. If we talk about the Berlin, B-E-R-L-I-N, means there was an order came from Berlin. And what was the order? I would like to tell you. Means order came from Berlin. For what? Order came from Berlin that tomorrow onwards there will be no teaching of French language. There will be no teaching of French language. Means tomorrow onwards German language will be taught. What will be taught tomorrow onwards? German language will be taught. So this news makes people very sad, because now they have lost their opportunity to learn their mother tongue. Even M. Hamel, he also becomes very sad when he comes to know this. Now he decides to take the last lesson and last class of the M. Hamel. Why does he decide? Earlier, he decided not to attend the class of M. Hamel. Why does he decide not to attend the class of M. Hamel? Because he has not prepared participle grammar which was taught by M. Hamel. Understood? But when he comes to know that it is the last lesson, it is the last class of M. Hamel, he decides to attend the last class of M. Hamel. When he missed what? He was in hurry to go to attend the class of M. Hamel. On the way he was checked. Look at here. On the way he was checked. He was checked by blacksmith. You can say the watcher. He checked him. Checked means what? He asked him, don't be hurry. You have enough time to cover your distance, to reach in the school. Who was asked by Franz? Franz was asked by blacksmith, means a watcher, don't be hurry. You have a good time to cover your distance. Now, he speaks to him, he says to him that, no, I am in hurry to reach there. When he goes there, he enters in the class. He asks permission. He asks permission. Excuse me, sir, may I come in? It was the first time when he notices in the school. And what does he notice? He notices in his school that everything was not as usual. Because if we talk about the means aura, if we talk about the environment, if we talk about the environment of the school, every time there was a commotion, there was a din, there was a hustle and bustle, there was a noisy classes, there was a recitation of the poem, recitation of the chapters, but it was a day. There was no commotion. He was unable to understand what happened in the school. Second thing, when he makes permission, it was the first time M. Hamel did not ask him what was the reason for his being late. Earlier he used to make question, what was the reason for his being late, and he used to punish. But it was the first time he could not punish him, he could not ask him for his being late. He asked him, go and take your class. He becomes very surprised, because it was the first time. And what happened the next time? He also realizes that M. Hamel was in his special dress. Special dress means occasionally he used to put on such a dresses on the occasion of the prize days or any cultural event or any program or inspection days. Inspection means, you know, that whenever officers they come to inspect the situation of the school. So I would like to tell three things very important, and you will have to keep in your mind. First, what did Franz notice in the class, which was not as usual? He notices that day that there was no as usual commotion in the school. Second thing, when he enters in the class, he was not punished and he was not asked for his being late. Third, he also noticed that Hamel, he was in his special Sunday dress. His special Sunday dress means, okay, generally he used to put on such a dresses on inspection day, prize day, any cultural or any school cultural programs. So, when he went and when he sat in his class, he realizes that it was a time the back benches means if we talk about the back of the class, it was not occupied by the people, it was vacant. But that day, it was occupied by the villagers, elderly people of the village. I mean to say what? It was the first time, not only the student, but also the elderly people of the school, they were taking class. So he was unable to understand what was the reason. What were the reasons behind it? Why did they come to attend the class? So he was not able to understand. He was watching towards the He was watching towards the Hamel. Hamel was very sad. He was unable to speak anything. Here is the question. Why did Hamel was not able to, was not able to understand? He was not able to speak because of only one reason. Reason is that now it was the last day to teach his students about his mother tongue and culture. Next day, tomorrow onwards, he was not able to teach his students about the values of his mother tongue. So he becomes very, unhappy, he becomes very sad. He means, are you getting what I'm saying to you? Look at the next point, that's very important to you. Now, he at once stands up from his chair and he starts addressing to his students. And before addressing to his students, he first asks his students that, now I am going to teach you participle grammar again. He teaches his students wholeheartedly, with due patience and sincerely, participle grammar to his students. It was the first time when Hamel was able to understand everything. It was the first time when Franz was able to understand. It was the first time when Franz was able to understand Hamel's teaching. Earlier he was not able to understand. Why? Because he was not taking interest in his teaching. But it was the first time Miss Franz was able to understand Hamel's teaching. Why? Because he paid attention towards Hamel's teaching. And what happened at that time? That Hamel starts making questions to one by one related to the participle grammar. Who starts making question? Miss Hamel. He starts making question to his students related to the participle grammar. Participle grammar. And if we talk about the participle grammar, now it was the first time when his turns come. When his turns, means turns came, he was able to answer Hamel's question. And he felt very relaxed that it was the first time he was able to answer the questions of Hamel. Now one of the most important thing I would like to tell you, that after that he gave them, who gave them? Hamel. He gave them, means friends and students and those who are seated back. Understood? Those who are seated back. Who are seated back? Elderly people of the village along with house. Understood? Along with house. Here is the question, that why did they come? Means Hausher and elderly people of the village, why did they come to attend the last lesson of the Miss Hamel? They came because of only one thing. They came to give respect for his 40 years sincere teaching. Okay. So what did I teach you? I told you that Hausher along with Miss elderly people of the village, why did they come? They came to give the respect. To whom? To Hamel for his 40 years sincere teaching. in one of the schools of the Alsace. Now I would like to teach you that he gave them writing task. I mean, writing task means written task. Who gave them? M. Hamel. He gave to his students written task. Everybody was busy to write, except Franz. Franz was watching to M. Hamel, and he realizes that M. Hamel was very sad. M. Hamel was very sad. So he realizes that M. Hamel was very sad, and he was unable to understand what was the reason. Everybody was busy, even by class was pin drop silence. Means at that time there was no Miss Bushel. There was a pin drop silence. There were only two sounds used to come at that time. First is the sound of the beetle. The sound of the beetle. B-E-E-T-L-E. The sound of the beetle. And Miss what? One of the pigeon, he was seated near the window and he was cooing. He was cooing means he was making Miss what sound. At that time, Franz realizes that it is one of the sarcastic line against the German power. Against the German power means Persian soldier. And it is the sarcastic line. Which type of sarcastic line? Which is spoken by whom? Spoken by Franz. And what did he realize? Look at that time when there was a complete silence. There were only two sounds used to come. First is the sound of the beetle. And another is the cooing sound, cooing voice of the one of the pigeon. And look at what made you at that time. What did Franz realize? Franz realized even he gave the sarcastic ideas. Will they make even the pigeon to coo in German? It is a sarcastic line spoken by Franz. Spoken by means he realized that Germany had the power to overcome our culture, tradition and mother tongue. But Germany had the power for what? To even ask pigeon to coo in German language. I mean to say, it is the sarcastic lines. And it is the one of the important lines of this chapter. So many times question has come related to this. Means what? Related to this line. And it is the value-based question also. I shall discuss later. Now, I would like to tell you that after that, M. Hamel, he was seated motionless. Motionless, he was not able to speak anything because he was very unhappy. He was very sad because tomorrow onwards, he had to leave. He will have to leave the club. Miss what? Place. At the same time, what happened? He at once left his chair. Who left his chair? M. Hamel. And he decides to address his students. What does he decide to address his students? I would like to tell you, my dear students, that he spoke to the worldly people. He addresses to the, Miss what? Those villagers who were seated back. And he spoke to them that, if you would like to keep your, Miss what, mother tongue, your culture, values, safe and sound, there is a need to keep your mother tongue. Miss what, there is a need to teach your younger generation, coming generation, for what, the value of the mother tongue. Now it is in your hand, whether to keep your mother tongue safe and sound, whether to keep your values safe and sound, you have to leave almost everything and become the slave. According to M. Hamel, he speaks to them that, you know, mother tongue is the key to the prison. This is another important line of this chapter. Mother tongue is key to the prison. I mean to say what? If you want to come from the slavery, slavery means what? Prison. If you want to come from the slavery, there is a need to keep our mother tongue safe and sound for coming generation. This line is spoken by whom? It's spoken by M. Hamel while addressing to the people and his students. While addressing, he became very, means what? Sad. But, and Franz, he realizes almost everything. And what happened at that time? While means what? While delivering lecture, while delivering, maybe making them, while making them understand, what does he realize? He realizes that now tomorrow onwards, I will be not here to teach my students and my people for what? About mother tongue and values. So he becomes very sad. Once again, he sits on his chair. Once again, he sits on his chair. Everybody is not, they are not able to speak anything. They all are realizing, they all are, what, blaming themselves. Even young Hamel, he also blames himself. Not only himself, but also the people of the, people of the village, even the students. For what? Because they lost their golden opportunity to learn their mother tongue. This type of blaming, I would like to tell you. Listen very carefully, my dear students. These things are very important to you. That first he blames, their parents. Actually, their parents, they do not allow them to attend the class. They allow them to work in the mill to earn, to earn money. Second things, which are very important, even the students, they are not quite interested to take the class of Ian Hamel. They are interested for what? They are interested to watch Persian soldier drilling, birds chirping in the place of attending class. Third is he blames himself. Why does he blame himself? Because whenever he goes for catching fish, or whenever he goes for fishing, he declares in his class holidays. Second thing that's very important, I would like to tell you, my dear students. And what is the thing that he also, he also asks his students to water the plant. So he also blames himself for not teaching, what? The values of the mother tongue. These things made him unhappy, sad. Now, I would like to tell you that they were not able to understand what was going on, but everybody was realizing, they all were blaming themselves that they lost the golden opportunity, one of the valuable time for not learning. Their mother tongue. After a while, Yam Hamel, he stands up, he takes a piece of chalk. He takes a piece of chalk and he wrote on the blackboard. And what did he write? Vive la France, one of the most important lines of this chapter. Vive la France means long live France. Long live France means at last of the class, he takes a piece of chalk and he wrote on the blackboard as large as he could. He wrote on the blackboard, Vive la France means long live France. But have you ever considered that how long live France will be? If you do not keep your mother tongue, if you do not keep your values, if you do not keep your rights safe and sound, close to your heart and mind for coming generation, how is it possible to see the long live France? So there is a deep sense of meaning in this line he wants to convey to the people of the village, even his students, that if you'd like to see the long live France, there is a need for what? There is a need to keep our values, to keep our mother tongue close to, your heart. At last, he declares that now class is dismissed. He takes his bag and baggage. He left that place along with his sisters. I would like to go through this is the brief summary of this chapter. Now, one of the important part of the vocabulary. Vocabulary, my dear students, I am not going to write here the complete vocabulary. When you go through the NCERT, and you will have to keep a pencil, you will have to underline the important vocabulary, and vocab power, word power, and if there is any query, you can ask to me. Now, if we talk about the important questions, there are a number of the important questions. First important question, I would like to tell you that what was the reason? Okay, now my dear students, at last I would like to summarize, I would like to conclude this chapter. First, my dear students, there is a need to keep in your mind the introduction, what is the background of this chapter and how many characters. If you would like to understand, first you will have to keep in your mind about the character of the Hamel and Franz. Both are very important. Franz, he was the French language teacher, understood, and he was teaching in one of the schools of the Alsace from 40 years, sincerely. Suddenly, what happened? France was defeated by a Persian army, and they lost, they lost two districts of the France, Alsace and Lorraine, in which it was the last day, last lesson of his teaching. There are a few things which are very important. I would like to conclude, my dear students, through this chapter. Alphonse Daudet wants to convey a message to the worldly people that we should keep our mother tongue, culture, values safe and sound. Hamel, he presents the same things because this chapter revolves around this character. The one of the most important three things are very important to keep in your mind. First is Vive la France. This is the very important lines of this chapter. Vive la France means long live France. Secondly is, will they make even the pigeon to Queen German? This line is spoken by French. Keep in mind. This line, important lines, is spoken by French. And this line is spoken by Hamel. Third thing is that, which type of changes French noticed when did he decide to take the last class? He noticed that there was no as usual commotion in the school. He noticed that the Hamel, he could not punish him for being late. He was in a special dress, and elderly people, they had occupied the back benches of the classroom. These things are very important to you all. If you would like to understand this chapter, there is a need to first go through the introduction. If there is any query, if there is any question, you can pause the video, you can write, and even the written notes will be given to you all. Thanks for watching.